Last December, I posted a video about a dodecagon world, and one person pointed out that if this thing rotates so quickly all the time, it will be flinging people off the ground, which was a good point, so I thought, alright, it's the sun that goes round and round. Two eels eternally chase each other, the red one brings the day, and the blue one brings the night. And I suppose the temperature gradient would look kinda like this, and since warm air rises and cold air sinks, I think this place would have very predictable winds, but I cannot figure out what those would be. And in any case, how warm is it here compared to here, or here compared to here? How quickly does air cool? How quickly does heat dissipate through air? I tried to look it up, but all I found was crazy maths, so I gave up. Months later, I decided to do some sci-fi worldbuilding, which was an amateur mistake. At the end of that video, I mentioned that a child that gets released into space will see the spaceship disappear in a blink of an eye, but then had it pointed out to me that the child and the spaceship would carry on traveling alongside one another. During acceleration, the ship would eventually overtake the child, and during deceleration, the child would overtake the ship. But I don't think that the child would ever reach the destination, because the course of the ship has acceleration and deceleration in mind, so the child would just become a nameless interstellar object. Or at least that's what I think. I don't actually know. And in a recent video, I mentioned that the constant growth of the petals that make up my flower-shaped world would make the soil that sits on top of it crack on a regular basis, but actually, it would not do that. I still cannot wrap my head around that. And I guess you could say, it's a magical world. If the laws of physics disagree with you, then you can just change them. But the problem is, if you change one thing, then you change everything.